This conference will now be recorded.
I'm just waiting 1 minute to wait someone else that is going to connect, and then we start. Okay. So I asked to my colleague that are going to participate to open the video and mic. Perfect. Thank you everyone to be here today. We are following a sort of calendar with our webinar, and we are today going to talk about MyOMAP and Living Now Digital Controls. As you know, MyOMAP, it was introduced 3 years ago to simplify the home automation process of configuration. And Living Now, that is the last, the latest wiring device range that BTCino launched. It's just from the beginning of this year, it received the digital controls that are connected with MyHome that change again the rules of the home automation, giving a completely new controls to the end user. Okay. So, as I say, home automation that we have in catalog now some years, the system, the protocol, so it's super well established and super robust system. We introduce MyOMAP on 2017, followed after by Living Now Wiring Device and Digital Control. So let's say just a second. The main scope of MyOMAP is to simplify the configuration of the system, because the main issue that the installer, regular installer, they were facing during installation of MyHome, it was the configuration of the system. We start with the configuration with configurator, numeric configurator, then we introduce MyHome Suite, the software, and to simplify more, thanks as well to the mobile, we introduced MyOMAP. Okay, today, for who doesn't know me, I'm Simone Ginelli, I'm the export manager of BTCino, in charge of several countries. Today, there is Alessandra Butti, that is the colleague in charge of the marketing for home automation, that will show you later the part related to Living Now Digital, and Aldi Mazza, that is the technical support, that is maybe some of you know him, because it's when you need an help, it's always super very welcome. And they will help me during the presentation. So we call the first part of MyOMAP today Welcome Simplicity, because the main target when we introduce MyOMAP, it was simplify as much as we can the configuration. As I say, put the configuration, it was something fine in the beginning when the system, they were quite small. Putting the manual configuration, it was creating sometimes mistakes, putting the same address twice. And then the software, it helped a lot to do this, and this was also time consuming. So today with MyOMAP, we have a software who is taking care of the configuration and what is going to install the system, have only to configure the graphical solution. So say, put the labels and associate to the labels the actuator or the push button. So the main object we need to do to digitalize on the mobile the MyOMAP system, it's first of all the MyOMAP server one, that is the web server connected to the bus and to the RJ45 that is connected to the router, and MyOMAP installed over the mobile. The touchscreen 7-inch, of course, it's optional, it's not mandatory, but is giving the possibility to have the controls you need always on the wall, because it's not related to the battery and the mobile that you forget in another room. So it's always present in one room and can be as well a video door entry unit. So I always recommend to install it. Now, for who already saw the webinar about the wiring device with Netatmo, I just want to remind the two different products. Wiring device with Netatmo, it's an evolvement of the wiring devices. So we have connected product using the wireless, so it doesn't need an additional wiring. And this position a bit lower MyOMAP, because it doesn't need cabling. It's a more easy architecture, mainly done for the flats. MyOMAP, so MyOMAP system with the bus, it's a solution for villas, for penthouse, or even for apartments where you need the integration of everything. Everything means temperature, you can have air conditioning, RGB lighting, you can create, I would like to say infinite scenarios, because you can create plenty. Let's say it's for more complete installation. So we have these two solutions in order to cover all the needs. So one is not replacing the other one. That's the important message. And it's what I said. We have new device scheduled for January 2021. So in my own, just to give you some view of the future. And as I said, we can control integrate almost everything. Then we have no configuration. We have devices association through the app. We have smart management for the end user. And the smart management for the user, it was the most important things, because what the key factor to make nice a system, of course, it must work, but have to be easy for the end user. The end user have to have an application that is easy and he can share in the house, in the family, to everyone, and can control all his house. And we will see later how the scenario can really help this. So this step for the installation that are quite easy, of course, the basic is take your bus system and connect. Later we will see some detail about the bus. Connect bus button, that controls over the bus, actuators, the power supply. We have one power supply for the bus and the Mayo server one. Then we have to install Mayo map over the mobile. We open the app. We have to log in for the first time, create the profile, and we will connect my home app with my home server one. How to do it? Over my home server one, there are two labels, one for the installer, one for the end user. There is a code. When you start the application, it's, let's say, the first one will be the installer. You need to put the code of the installer, because the installer is the one who create the architecture. The end user, he cannot modify the architecture. He can modify the name of the labels. He can modify the scenario. But the process to start is exactly the same. So code that you read on the label, you put the code, and you start to create the association. Association is quite easy. We enter inside the configuration. The first things we have to do is to select the rooms we have, because we can have different rooms. Then for each room, we create the label. The label are, let's make an example, kitchen. Inside the kitchen, we have two lights. So we will choose the label of the light, and we write the name exactly of the light. And we have to go over the push button to do the association. So it's a quite simple process. Just click my home app, it recognizes the device, and then you put the name of the device. Then, that we will see later in a dedicated chapter, then the user can create as well scenarios based on time, condition, and geolocalization. That is the really nice things and advantage of the My Home App. The system is connected to the cloud. This it means we have the possibility to control everything, even when we are in the office. We don't have to be connected to the Wi-Fi. We can be as well outside. Regarding the bus, I remind that the bus, that probably most of you know it, we have the bus cable in catalog, and we can use the gray one or the white one that you use for the video, because both are fine. Are two wires not polarized and twist, so you can connect as you like. Then it's 27 volt, and let's say that is the most easy part, the bus, and it can stay in the same pipes of the 230 volts cables because it's protected. The bus can be pulled in mainly in two ways, and then depend to the piping you have. Using the old house, we have what is called free structure, because you have maybe a distribution box, and the switches, they are connected in chain one after the other one. Usually in the new house, we have a star structure, one distribution box, and all the boxes are connected to this distribution box, that it make a bit simple the cabling. The bus doesn't have any problem. You can install both way a mix solution, no problem. There is only a tip to remind: it is never close a circle or a loop. If you take, for example, the one room, the one in the bottom on the left, that you see that you have a C, you never close the ring, because otherwise it can create problem on the bus. This is the only tip to remind. And we have two kind of power supply: the E49 for less than 600 milliamp, so for small system, and we have the regular 146 ADCN that is 1.2 amp, that is the most used. If you adapt, use the 46 ADCN. Then the other things is maximum length of the bus. It's 500 meter for a bus, for inside the flat, inside the house, and 250 meter, the farthest point from the power supply. So you can go 250 meter one side, 250 meter to the other side. That is quite a lot. If you exceed, we have the interface we are going to see as well. Remember that with my home app, the most important limit to keep in mind, we can manage 175 loads that are addresses in reality, the 175. So there is, can be light, shutters, presence sensor, whatever we have in catalog, contact interface, whatever. Everything is connected with the bus. That is an address, that is addressable. What we have to remind in this case, it's the extension of the bus can have a physical extension. So it means we need more than 500 meters of bus. So we can put, for example, you move between different floors, or we have a quite long surface. We can put up to four interface. The interface is the F422, up to four interfaces. These four interfaces, they have the physical configuration. So just to extend the bus, but we keep 175 addresses. If you exceed 175, today, unfortunately, we cannot exceed this limit. So you cannot use the logical limit, the logical expansion, sorry, of the configuration of the interface. We can manage temperature controls. Temperature controls, it's connected to the bus like the rest. It can manage the normal valve on off, the proportional valve, 110 volts, air conditioning, and we have the possibility to integrate with air conditioning system as well. Then function control with light, of course, on and off. We can control as well RGB lighting using a third party device and Philips Hue that already built in the driver inside the My Home Server One. So give the possibility to control almost everything. Rolling shutter, we have two actuators, the one is do up and down and the one that can as well control the position. So you can create scenario where you can say open at 30% inside the scenario. And you can control socket, door lock, there's you can use your fantasy to control the system. Temperature control, we saw energy consumption. We can see the actual consumption of a load. And we as well integrate the audio. Audio. As Le Grand Group, we have Nuvo sound system. We can control as well Sonos. That is more end user product. And this, it will be control inside the scenario. We have here, probably quite small, in the main page, we have three push buttons in the bottom with all the house that is divided by rooms, where in each room we can personalize putting a picture of the room, so it will become much more immediate to see which is the kitchen, the toilet, and because we have the picture of our house. And these scenarios and the favorites. Favorites are the most used in order to don't go inside the bedroom, go to the shutter, and then control the shutter, you can put directly the shutter of the bedroom that you are using every morning. The favorite. And then the scenario. Scenario, we have the possibility to do really quite a lot of type of scenario. A scenario can be controlled by a push button in the system. That is the trigger, or based on an object that changes status. For example, we can put a sensor outside that in case of temperature high and sun is close contact, and we have curtains outside or shutter that we move, and in case of wind we can as well do the same. Then this is connect as well the weather condition, or we can have the geolocalization, that it mean if I'm arriving at home I can do a scenario with only one things to highlight, that is the telephone. It gives you a notification and you have to click OK, because otherwise the scenario doesn't start. And then preset timers that are probably the most used, that you can create a scenario based on days of the week, weekdays or single days that you select, weekend, and do an action at a certain time. One typical example of the scenario, that is the one I like more, is in the morning at 7, open the shutters, switch on the music of Nuvo system, and maybe do something else. You can create a scenario like this. Automatize during the whole week. And if you enter in scenario, you can enable and disable, because maybe you are leaving for holiday and you want to disable this scenario because you don't want to open the shutter and start the music when you're not at home. So the end user can do it. And this is a very easy step. You just enter in the scenario and in the modification, you can put enable and disable. We said already that MyOMAP it's work everywhere. So from any place we can control the house. Important things that the house is connected with the internet. That is a basic things because it's everything based on cloud. And then let's pass to the touchscreen 7-inch. Touchscreen 7-inch is part of the system, is the interface with the system that usually is installed in living room, entrance, where the rooms that are most used, because we always want a place where we can see the temperatures, we can have up to 20 controls, so and scenario together, in order to control the most important things quite easy, because we just go there, it's always on and on off. And as well is a door entry system solution. As a movement sensor, so if you go close, you switch on the video automatically. It can show the instant consumption of a load, as you can see here. And installation, of course, it's super easy, like the other product that we have in catalog. And can be used as well as door entry unit. So you have two main functions, one for my home, and the other one that is the door entry unit inside the house. So instead to have a door entry monitor and the touchscreen, we combine in one item both solution. And for the door entry, it uses door entry app. We decide to keep an application dedicated for door entry in order to have a lighter solution and direct, because when someone is ringing, we want to see immediately who it is, and we need the main function that is reply, close the call, and open the gate. That's the main function necessary, because you know it's coming UPS, is ringing once, you don't reply, they go. So wherever you are, you can reply and talk with them and eventually open the gate and say leave the package there. We have two kinds of installation. Product is the same. Regular installation, it's wall mounted. It's not deep, it's 1 centimeter, something like this. And we have a flush mounted box for the wall in case we want completely flash mode. Architecture is quite easy. We have bus input and additional power supply because it needs an additional power supply. Bus, of course, connected with my own server, so it's integrated. When you connect it and you give the power to the power supply, you recognize my home app devices, and then you just need to select in the page. There is add the plus you see in the bottom right. You add the point-to-point light or the scenario that you want to control, because you never want to control all the house from the touchscreen, because there's no sense. You will put the one you need to use from the living room, is if it's installed, for example, in the living room. And this is showing the screens of the door entry. You have the video, reply, and close. So we improve the user experience of my home, mainly thanks to my home app and my home touch, of course, because we integrate the video door. And one important thing that I didn't mention yet, that personally I'm using a lot and more, is the Google Assistant or Amazon Alexa, the voice assistant. This system, it works with iOS and Android. You find on the store, on the both store, the application. And let's say the vocal assistant, it's surely the most attractive, because you can activate a scenario just saying, hey Google, open the shutter, switch on the garden light, bam, and in 1 second you're done without to unlock the screen, enter in the my home app, enter inside the scenario, and then select the scenario. So I have to say that the vocal assistant is a really great user experience today. Regarding my home app, it's yes, I saw a question about vocal assistant when you're going to add Siri. Yes, Siri today is not yet embedded. We have in the our work in progress this, and will arrive. You know, it's requested from who has the iPhone. Okay, the first part about my home app, it's done. Now we have Alessandra, but I didn't heard yet. Alessandra.
Yeah, good morning everybody. Do you hear me?
Okay, perfect. So Alessandra now is going to show you the, let's say, the most fancy part, that is the one regarding living now digital controls.
Thank you, Simone, may I share my screen, please?
Yes, it's of course.
Okay, so do you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. So, good morning everybody. I'm Alessandra Butti, Marketing Manager of Home Automation, and I'm going to explain to you our new digital controls that are part of the Living Now program and are based on my home app installation. First of all, this project is part of the Living Now program, that is actually based on the concept of innovation, quality, and excellence, with the aim to reaffirm to the BTC no value, but propose together with aesthetically innovation also a technological advanced solution totally personalized by the end user. In this map, you can see all the Live In House solution proposed by BTCino based on two axes that actually represent the functions and the user experience. So, to better explain to you, at this axis crosses, we found the Live In House traditional solution. Increasing a bit of functionality and user experience, we found our solution Live In Now with Netatmo. Then we have the solution of Live In Now Mio Map that actually increases the functionality since it's based on the home automation system of Mio Map. What we have done with the new Live In Now digital controls. Of course, the depth of the functionality is the same as the one based on Mio Map, but we increase the user experience. And in the next slides, I will explain better to you how. This is actually so our top group solution in order to do business in the residential project. These are the three main pillars on which this project of the digital controls is based. So the design, evolutivity and flexibility, and the voice dialogue. Starting from the design, we actually focused on the main idea to give to our end user the best experience. This is why these controls doesn't have aesthetical plate because we decide to give to end user full space dedicated to interaction. On the controls, we have discrete LEDs that represent actually technology and the total personalization. In fact, it will be possible to personalize also the symbols and the icons on the controls. And the surface that is actually touch in order to ensure a unique experience. Another important pillar is the one of evolutivity and flexibility. Basically, what the end user can do with these digital controls. It can move one control from one box to another, keep the same function configured. It can extend the control just replacing the frame. I will better explain to you this with some images of the architecture. But basically, just on three module and four module box, we created some dedicated frames. The frame is the support on which the controls are installed. And for example, replacing the three module frames with a 3+1, it is possible to add one controller. And finally, we give the total personalization to end user thanks to the app. So through Mio Map, the end user can also personalize which functions are managed on that control. If you want to add the control of one light, if you want to add one scenario on that control, if you want to change what is actually configured on the controller. Talking about the possibility to move one control from one box to another, this actually represents to us two main advantages. On the installer side, we have total configuration flexibility. So also when the client during the fine-tuning phase may ask some adjustments or change, thanks to this, the installer can easily adapt the system to the client's needs, avoiding mandatory works. And together with this, we have also many advantages for the end user. So the possibility to auto-adapt the system without the help of the installer. Also in line with the potential future house changes, We all know that when we buy a house, we may change during the years and while we leave this house, how we use the spaces and the rooms in the house. With this system, you can easily adapt your house to all your future life changes. So, in this slide, I show you how you can extend the system with the replacement of a frame. Basically, this is the architecture. You will have, for example, this is the three module box, the Live In Now support that is the same support of all the Live In Now range. And then we have this reference. This is the three module frame dedicated for the digital controls. On this frame that you install on the support, you can put your digital controls. What if you want to add the one control? No problem. You replace this frame that is three modules with a 3+1. And so you can easily put the same controls that you had before, just adding a new one and configure it as you prefer, thanks to the app. This is the example on the three module box. We can do the same on the four module box. We have a four module frame dedicated for this box, and this can be easily replaced by the 4+1 frame in which you can install an additional command. What about the two module box? We actually created a dedicated frame, and thanks to this frame that basically is the same. Aesthetically, is the same that you can see here, so it's the same as the three module box, but behind it can be solo on a two module box. So we give the possibility to have up to three controls on a two module box, thanks to the dedicated frame. What about creation and personalization of the control? As I said to you, thanks to my home app, also the end user could easily adapt and configure the control and change the configuration and add additional function. This is a simplified step by step that what the end user can do through the app. Basically, you touch the control, you see what is configured in the control on that control. For example, here we see there is a table lamp light on off that is configured on this control. What we can do, for example, we want to add another light. So we touch on the plus that we see, we decide which function we want to add, for example, light on off. We follow all the procedure, and basically, what we will see at the end is that on the same control that I had before, I have now, together with the table lamp light that I had at the beginning, also the doorway light. I save the configuration, and now I can manage that two lights from that control. Another important news of this range is the voice control Alexa built-in. What is this voice control? It's a flash-mounted vocal assistant. It's an Amazon Alexa assistant natively integrated in our My Home App system. You can put this in every room as an integral part of the system. We can say that in this way, Alexa can be by your side. And thanks to this flash-mounted installation, you don't have to find a place to your vocal assistant. It's simply installed on the wall. This is why this is suitable for every context and even for the spaces in which maybe you don't have exactly the space to put a vocal assistant. So, just to go a little bit in depth with this type of controls, we have basically two types of control, the light control and the full control. What we can do with these two types? On the light control, we can manage up to two lights in one module. I mean, lights and objects with an off function. I mean, a single light, group of light, and general lights. What happened to the control when I turn on the light? The LED becomes blue. This is because on the lights, we need to give a feedback to the user in order to show if someone is on or off. Of course, this LED intensity is adjustable by the app. What about the full control? The full control is the other type of the control that, together with lights, so the same as light control, you can manage the lights. Actually, on this control, you can manage not two, but three control, three lights. So the on-off function, same function as already explained on the light control, can be managed by the full control. But together with this, on the full control, we can manage also shutters, dimmer, and scenarios. We can personalize the symbol. And thanks to this onboard proximity sensor that maybe you don't see very well, but how I can distinguish the full control when from the light control when they are turned off is that on the full control you have this proximity sensor that actually what does it do? The symbol, thanks to this proximity sensor, the symbol comes up just when we are approaching the control. So just when we want to do an action in order to do not bother with too many lights or symbols, we put this proximity sensor. Of course, also in this case, the LED intensity is adjustable. About personalization of the symbol, we have just some basic one. Here you can see some examples about shutters. So just to be clear, the example of shutter, I told you here up to three function. One shutter is three function because we will have up, stop, and down. Same as dimmer. So on one control, you can put actually the management of one shutter, of one dimmer, but of three on-off lights and of three scenarios. Here you can see some examples of the symbols. What about the Alexa built-in? As I already said to you, on this device, we have exactly the same function as the Alexa Amazon Assistant. And of course, as you can imagine, this device must be configured by the end user. This is why there is a dedicated app, the Voice Control Alexa app. So when the end user actually interact with the system, he has to download the app and easily configure it in order to get the link with his Amazon Alexa account. Together with this, that is a three module monoblock, we have Alexa, let's say, in the middle with this speaker, but on the left and on the right we have two lights control, the one that I just explained to you. So basically what you can do is to manage maximum four lights together with the vocal assistant that is installed in the middle. For this device, we created a dedicated reference item that is additional power supply. In most of the cases is required because of the consumption of the Alexa device. Here we can see easily how is the architecture of new digital controls. We have the example of the three module box. It will follow the example of the two modules. But as I told you, three module box, the support that is the same as the Live in Now range. Here we go with the connection module. The connection module is the only item actually required in this installation in the box because it's the one cabled with the bus. Here we have the example of some flash-mounted actuator. So if we want, we can use the DIN actuator in the cabinet. Otherwise, we have this dedicated reference of flash-mounted actuator that you can put in the box together with the connection module. What we suggest is also to put some blanking modules. So if we don't close, let's say, all the modules with the connection module and some actuators, it's a good idea to put the blanking module in order to separate as much as we can the wired part from the one to which the end user can interact. So, as we said, since the end user could remove the rectified frame, for example, replace it with a 3 plus 1, we don't want him to, let's say, face any problems. So if the cable part is well isolated, also with the help of the blanking module, it's the best. This is the electrified frame dedicated to the three module box. We can see we have some aesthetical bars that actually can help us to, let's say, have a better aesthetical solution with the controls. This is exactly the same architecture we may have with the voice. So what we can do is remove these aesthetical bars, and as you can see from this slide, put the Alexa voice control. The frame is exactly the same. So as you can see, the code is the same. I would like to add just an additional information about the configuration due to this architecture. So as Simone explained to you, when the installer is configuring the system, he has to follow the procedure on the MyOMAP app, and so configure actuators and the command and so on. What is new with this architecture is that it actually this control, for example, is not directly speaking with this actuator. I mean, if we don't want this one can speak to an actuator with in another box. So what about the configuration side? With the digital control, the installer must scan all the systems, so install all the controls, but when he has to configure the actuator, he has to quickly remove the frame with the installed controls in order to physically touch the actuator if he wants to do the physical configuration. Otherwise, on the app, you have the list of actuator and you proceed that way. So moving to the two modules box, here we go with the architecture. We created one dedicated support for this two module box that is able to support a three module frame. So basically on the two module box, we have the space, of course, of the compulsory connection module. Together with that, we may put one blanking module or one flash mounted actuator if the installer doesn't want to use the one in the cabinet. So a three module frame that is a dedicated item for the two module box on which we can put our digital control. Same, if we remove the aesthetical bars, we can install the Alexa voice control. These are actually some additional reference for the thermoregulation and the sockets that actually are the one of living now already existing in the MyOMAP. And to sum up, which are the main advantages of this new solution? First of all, the installer has to manage a low numbers, few codes for an entire offer. Together with this, as I already said, configuration flexibility. So during the fine tuning, you can change if the client requires some additional controls or what. All these avoiding mandatory works, and also the opportunity for three module boxes installation using the same MyOMAP app. Advantages for the clients is a system through which you can control your house so easy and intuitive. Thanks to the app, you can also now personalize all your control. So, Simone, if you agree, I will go quickly with the some information about communication tools and the catalog. Are you okay?
Yes, yes. I would like only to stress what you already said, that one is the connection module, the one has the bus behind that is connecting the frame, electrified frame, can be in every point of the box, because the electrified frame is like a bus bar behind, and every place is fine. And the other things that is really nice is that if after that someone is living inside the house and they need an additional command, they don't need to, because usually there is the problem, there's no any more space in the box. Now we just replace T-frame, put in the one with one additional module, and you have an additional electrified key cover. So that's really the beautiful advantage of living now digital. Okay.
So basically, about communication tool, we have technical sheet, video, brochure. Probably you already see on BTCino International, we have the launch video. And we realized some tutorials in order to better explain the architecture of this product. Here we have just an example of panel, if you would like to better understand the functionalities of this system. This is basically the list of the materials that you need in order to exploit, let's say, all the functionalities, the main functionalities. And with the product offer, I will go quickly through the catalog. As I said, we may consider between a flush-mounted device, frames, and aesthetical device. In the flush-mounted device, we have the connection module. As I already said, is the one compulsory for every box because it's the one cabled with the bus. And as Simone said, you can put in every, let's say, module of the box, no matter where. If you want flush-mounted actuator, if you let's say as alternative as the at the one in the cabinet, so we have the light actuator and the shutter actuator, and then the connection module with additional power supply that is dedicated to the Alexa voice control. For the frame, first of all, the colors, same range colors as Living Now, so we have white, black, and sand. We have the frames dedicated for the two modules box, the frame dedicated to the three modules box. There are the three module frame and the 3+1 module frame. And then finally, the one dedicated to the four module box. So four module frame and 4+1 module frame. Aesthetical device, light control. So for the management of up to two lights. Full control for the management up to three lights, shutters, dimmer, and scenarios. And then voice control, that is a three module monoblock, voice Alexa natively integrated. And together with that, the management of maximum four lights. And then finally, the blanking module. So an aesthetical blanking module, if we don't want to put so many controls on one box, we can close the installation with just an aesthetical one. Here's some information about this flush-mounted device. So again, the connection module is the only one that need to be cabled to the bus. On-off actuator for lights, on-off actuator for shutters. Here are the frames, so with all the ranges of colors. This frame for the two module box, these six frames for the three module box, and finally these frames for the four module box. And then again, the aesthetical device that I already explained to you with all their characteristic. So, for my side, that's all. I don't know if you have any questions.
Yes, that's why I see that Alvin is super active to reply to the customer.
Good.
So, thank you for everyone, because I don't see any question. I don't know if Alvin, you want to add something, but I think that we touch almost everything or everything.
Yes, nothing else to add.
Okay. Remember, if you are not subscribed, subscribe to our newsletter and stay tuned for the next.
Simone, is it possible to view this offline? I see it's recorded. Would it be possible to view it for how
Yes.
do we get the link?
I can send you the link. Let's say
Please send me.
from tonight we should have the link.
Okay, please send me.
Perfect.
Thank you
Okay.
very much. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Offer. So, no other question? Okay.